My name's Ben McMullen. I'm one of the elders. I've been an elder for about 6 years. And I'm going to give my testimony. If you have any questions about it or want to talk to me, I'd love to talk to you. So see me afterwards. And here we go. I was raised in a Catholic family. Although we are Catholic, we only went to church maybe a couple times a year, if that. So I didn't have much direction through my high school years or my 20s and 30s. And, I thought I was my own boss. I thought I was in control of my own life. And Jesus was not my Lord and Savior. I led a very sinful life at that time and, did what I wanted within the law, of course. But I did what I wanted and didn't really think about Christianity or anything like that. Fast forward, I got married to my wife, DJ. We had a daughter, Madeline, and I have a stepdaughter, Kayla. And early in our marriage, we wanted to give our kids some kind of a direction, some kind of a experience in Christianity. So we started the church shop around the area here. And we did that for a few months, and we ended up here at Faith Free. But at the same time, I was watching things, talking, or reading things that said, there is no God. There's no proof of God. So at that time, I was really sitting on a fence. I was like, am I going to be an atheist, or am I going to be a Christian? And I remember one morning I was watching one of those programs on National Geographic or one of those programs that tells you there's no God. And but I felt God tugging at me, and I went in to talk to DJ, and I said, if we're going to be doing this church thing, I want to do it 100%. So we started attending Faith here pretty regularly, and I started hearing something different. I started hearing there is a God. There's a God that loves me, and there is proof that there's a God. So we were here for a few months, and after Rick's sermon, one of his sermons back then, he said, if you want to accept Christ into your life, go back to the library, and there'll be someone waiting there for you. So God was tugging at me, and I went back there. I talked to one of the elders there, and we prayed. I confessed my sins. We talked about it, and I accepted Christ into my life back in the library in this church. After that, I look back on that time, and there really wasn't a big change in me right away. It's not like some people where all of a sudden, bam, you're a Christian and you change. Mine took a little while. But I look back on that time, and that's when my life changed. I got more involved with the church. I started going to growth groups. I started greeting people at the door. I served coffee. I did whatever I could just to serve God. And I got involved with the children's ministry for a little bit. And I didn't do those things because I thought I had to be accepted into heaven. I did those things because I just wanted to. There was a passion inside of me that I just loved to serve the Lord. And after that went on for a few years, I was praying to God again, God, what do you want me to do? I want to do more for you. And I prayed to him for probably a good year or two. And an elder finally called me up and said, would you like to be an elder? And I prayed about it, talked about it, and finally became an elder. But I don't do these things because I think you have to work to get to heaven. We know in Ephesians chapter 2, 8, 9, it says you're saved by grace and not by deeds. So, and as an elder, I love serving this church. I love all you guys. I love being an elder, and I love doing God's will. And I ask that God works through me every day to do what he wants to do through me. So if you would have asked me, before I got saved in the church, or back in the library there, if you would have asked me or told me that I'd be so involved with the church, I probably would have laughed at you or told you to get out or told you crazy or something like that. But God's working through me, and I just love him for it. And that's my testimony. I'm sticking to it. And and if you guys want to talk to me more about it or whatever, look me up. If you want to talk about your testimony, my testimony, whatever you want to talk about, I'd love to talk to you. God bless you guys.